Hello there! I'm Rose Guerrero, Research Director for the Historical Society of Palm Beach County, and welcome to the latest episode of Quarantine Chronicles from the Archives. I promise I'm not playing the ukulele today. We are celebrating Asian Pacific Heritage Month and Haitian Heritage Month in May. Palm Beach County is a diverse community of people who have come from all over the country and the world. So let's grab a cold beverage and let's learn about two men who came from opposite sides of the world, George Morikami and Joseph Bernadel, and how they made Palm Beach County their home. Haitians have been immigrating to Florida for decades, bringing along with them their determination to thrive. As their community has grown, so has their involvement and influence in a variety of professions, including politics, law, medicine, and education, just to name a few. The original immigrants challenged their children and grandchildren to embrace the opportunities America had to offer, while remembering their own rich cultural heritage. Major Joseph Bernadel was born and educated in Haiti and immigrated to the U.S. in 1975. He served 22 years in the U.S. Army, rising to the rank of major, and was awarded the Legion of Merit, an award for exceptionally meritorious conduct in the performance of outstanding services and achievements. Along with a bachelor's in science and administration from the University of Hawaii, Major Bernadel also holds a graduate degree in Latin American and Caribbean affairs. He also speaks four languages. How many languages do you speak? Does knowing a little bit of Spanish count? So what makes Major Bernadel so interesting? He is the first person of Haitian heritage to open a public school here in the United States, the Toussaint Louverture School of Art and Social Justice in Lake Worth. The Haitian community continues to thrive here in Palm Beach County, so happy Haitian Heritage Month. To celebrate Asian Pacific Heritage Month, I want to tell you a story about a group of Japanese settlers that came to Boca Raton in 1904, led by a man named Joseph Sakai. Invited by Henry Flagler's Model Land Company, Joe Sakai and the settlers created a farming community in which they named Yamato, an ancient name for Japan. This farming community planted pineapples, citrus, and other vegetables. One of those settlers was George Morikami, who was born in Japan and emigrated to the United States in 1906 to join the Yamato colony. At only 19 years old, Morikami planned on making a quick fortune and return to Japan, but he never left Florida. The first 3 years of Morikami's efforts were spent repaying the cost of passage from Japan. Discouraged, he moved to Brevard County, where he learned English for a year. When he returned, he borrowed tools, seed, and land in order to plant tomatoes. He began to prosper, but like many, when the Great Depression hit, he lost the majority of his property. As World War II broke out, Morikami's crops failed and the bank refused him a loan. He wasn't interned like other Japanese in the United States. However, a guard was placed in his home and his movements were restricted. The U.S. Army Air Corps seized the Yamato colonists' land to build a training base. This eventually became Florida Atlantic University and the Boca Raton Airport. After the war, Morikami started again, purchasing a small farm in which he worked until he died. He also began acquiring land at $15 to $17 per acre. He also became a U.S. citizen in 1967. Morikami wanted to give back to his new country and to salvage the memory of the Yamato colony. So he gave 40 acres to the University of Florida for an experimental farm and nearly 200 acres to Palm Beach County. Morikami died in 1976, a year after the groundbreaking of the Morikami Park, home to the Morikami Museum and Japanese Gardens. These two stories are just small samples of the many stories of diverse communities here in Palm Beach County. I hope you enjoyed them. Happy Asian Pacific Heritage Month. Happy Haitian Heritage Month. And if you want to learn more about the Historical Society of Palm Beach County, check us out. Say bye, Violet.